classroom chemistry? What's this?
Thanks for asking. Let me tell ya. The foreword has the essence of elementary science, focusing on the program of studies. The book also has the program of studies skills, attitudes, and understandings right from the Alberta curriculum. There's also a considerable amount of background information for teachers over a number of pages. I would always encourage a little more reading though to get a thorough background. There's also a great set of activities for you to use. You'll see there's also an appendix that has a great number of reproducible masters you can use and a material list so you know what you need to purchase for each of the great activities in the book. Today, we're going to do the Great Bulge. Depending on your class, you could follow the procedure exactly as written, or I'm going to model an inquiry approach where kids get to select their variables.
Yay! But wait, what's the Great Bulge about?
The Great Bulge is about looking at a liquid and how it forms on top of a penny.
Like these?
Now this activity uses water on pennies, but I would like to think of this more as an investigation with a manipulated variable. That's a variable you change to see if it's having an effect. So, Janice, what variable could we manipulate if we're looking at the Great Bulge on pennies?
How about we manipulate the type of substance?
That's a great idea. And in this experiment, the responding variable is the number of drops that can rest on the surface of the penny. Shall we measure that?
For sure.
What substance had the biggest bulge?
Water!
Yay! We're going to do an experiment where we're going to float a paper clip in some water.
How about we manipulate a variable?
Good idea. What would your problem statement be?
What is the effective type of substance, which is the manipulated variable, on the ability to float a paper clip, which is the responding variable?
Well, why don't you come around and we'll get started. You know, you couldn't get the paperclip to float in any of them, but finally you succeeded doing exactly the same thing in water. How did you manage to make it float?
By not breaking the surface.
Oh, and so you made a little hook. How ingenious, yeah. Janice.
Thank you. Yeah.
Let's look at a video of some really important uses of water.
You can bathe in it. You can clean with it. You can store your food in it. Plants and animals need it. Here, pickles. Come on. You can water plants with it.
Water's so useful. This looks like a really useful book. I could really learn from it.
And you can too.